there is something very special that I never realized that it will become a profession. I was composing music, I was improvising a lot, I was spending a lot of time in my piano. It was really the way to escape for me.
It always means a lot to me. Music never means any less to me, you know, whether I play it for 8,000 people or just for myself. The music is always the thing that I adore, that I admire, and that I love.
It's about music, about art, but it's important to think about the politics as well, as an artist, to deliver a message for the social thing, in order to let people think about what they can do to make the world a little bit better, to live together.
C'est dans ce respect de l'identité, c'est-à-dire de la culture dans la durée, que s'inscrit pour moi le festival de musique de Montauban.
And for me, this is really the place between the sun, the sky, and the sea. And to put the music inside, it's like just one of the most beautiful things that anyone can imagine.
Je pense que c'est parmi les murs d'Europe les plus chanceux, les murs les plus mélomanes d'Europe, puisqu'ils ont vu défiler vraiment tous les plus grands, toutes les plus grandes légendes avec des programmes extraordinaires, des moments de musique complètement géniaux.
Montauban is a really special music festival. I mean, it's got an incredible history of great artists performing here over many years. This is now the 69th edition of it. I mean, what's really spectacular is you just need to look around. I mean, I think this is probably the most beautiful festival stage on this planet. It's just really amazing.
It's one of those places that I could say that I was a little bit dreaming to play one day on that stage, and I really felt on stage that something special was happening, and I feel a little bit in my world totally connected with all the elements around, audience, but also the nature around, the city, the walls, and the history of the city and of the festival.
What is really specific to this festival is that it's an open air festival, and you are there, you're just enjoying this atmosphere, you're feeling secure because you have all those historical buildings around you, and with that natural sounds that you have from the sea, from the people who are walking, from the restaurants, it's magical, it's unique.
Un homme que nous avons gardé dans notre mémoire collective, qui s'appelait André Broch, qui était hongrois. Il dirigeait la radio hongroise à Paris pendant la guerre. Un jour est passé sur le parvis de ce qui n'était pas encore la basilique Saint-Michel. Et il a eu une émotion. Une émotion qui est née de la vision d'un cadre théâtral, à la fois monumental et intime, qui est celui du parvis de la basilique. Et ainsi, André Broch a créé un petit côté démiurge. Il a créé l'ADN du Festival de musique de Montauban.
Dans son ADN, il y a d'une part l'excellence, la beauté. Alors évidemment, dans différents types, différents formats de concerts, et évidemment des récitals de piano qui ont marqué fortement l'histoire de ce festival et que nous poursuivons, une histoire qui se poursuit. L'authenticité, l'excellence, l'authenticité parce que nous sommes dans un cœur de ville où la ville ne s'arrête pas, évidemment, les logements sont occupés. Donc on est dans un site à la fois complètement naturel, vivant, de sa propre énergie, et en même temps où il y a des parenthèses enchantées avec ces moments de musique d'exception.
Playing outdoors is sometimes very difficult because there is no acoustic outdoors, because you need walls to project the sound. In Menton, this place is of course absolutely extremely beautiful.
And the funny thing is, when you come here, you're thinking, okay, it all looks beautiful, but for the music it's probably not ideal. But actually even sounds very nice. Because the square is surrounded by buildings, there's also reflection for the sound, and so even musically it's a great experience to play here.
And then of course I really love the fact that you can hear a little bit from far away the sound of the sea, the wind. It creates a different feeling, really, that I really love.
What is good about the festival is that you can really meet, you can really listen to the artists that you know, but also you can discover lots of artists. Like in the Museum Jean Cocteau, we have those what we call small concerts, but they are not small at all.
To play in the museum is a really nice and special vibe and feeling, especially with this music video performance. It's nice if we have an intimate atmosphere. The audience was super close to me, and I really like to feel them super close. So I only have really great and good impressions.
To play for other people, which is a little bit exhibitionist, let's say, was the main difficulty for me. And I've noticed at the beginning of my career that the most disturbing thing was to transform a little bit the way I was playing because of the audience. And more I decided to create on stage this bubble, and I noticed that the more I felt completely alone on stage, the more I could share with the audience.
Even though I don't know people personally, really, mostly, of course, in the audience, but when you come back to a festival again and again and again, there's a feeling like we know each other a little bit. There is something to build on, like in a relationship. And music is also a lot about something that happens between people and about the trust that people build. Maybe it's an illusion as an artist, but I find this building of something with an audience is an amazing thing.
So one of the most important things for me is each time I go on stage, I don't have to think about what I'm gonna play, what is happening. For me, it's just about having fun.
I try to be in a kind of more meditative way of thinking and of hearing the sound I produce. And this is actually what creates a pleasure for me that I can really share. And I think then the concert could be an experience more than entertainment.
When I play as a pianist with an orchestra, it's a concerto. So there is the element of playing together, but there's also, there's supposed to be some kind of a competition. So where you play also against each other, where you don't agree, the orchestra says one thing, I say another thing. And that's a feeling that I personally actually need. Yamaha has certainly developed over the last years to become one of the big piano companies that quite rightfully are present on international stages. And here, historically, it's always been Yamaha in Menton. I'm very happy with the piano. It's got a pretty big range of expression and it's very personal. It also reacts very chamber music-like.
Je dois dire au passage que dans cette approche un peu globale, le partenariat que nous avons, dont nous honore depuis une trentaine d'années, Yamaha, est pour nous un élément considérable de mesure de notre crédibilité et en même temps de capacité à prendre des risques. Donc on est vraiment très, très reconnaissant à Yamaha d'être là depuis si longtemps.
Sur les projets futurs et l'avenir et ce 70e anniversaire. Alors, c'est clair que c'est dans l'histoire de ce festival un moment tout à fait important, mais que j'ai envie d'être, que ce moment soit tourné vers l'avenir. Je pense que c'est toujours important de savoir d'où l'on vient, de connaître son histoire, mais pas pour uniquement s'en glorifier et regarder derrière soi, mais bien plutôt pour construire l'avenir, pour pouvoir faire que cette histoire qui a duré près de 70 ans puisse durer au moins autant. Et rendez-vous pour le 140e anniversaire du Festival de Menton avec, j'espère, bien sûr, les pianos Yamaha.